Happy morning, dear children. How are you all? Hope you all are doing the reading practice of English. Dear children, today we will start a new story and it is in our lesson 2, Little Girls Wiser Than Men. Dear children, we all have friends, right? And sometimes we do fight a little with them. We do have small arguments or quarrels, right? But soon we make up, right? हम तुरंत दोस्ती कर लेते हैं या थोड़े वक्त के बाद दोस्ती हो जाती है, right? We all quarrel with our friends while playing. How much time does one take to forget about the quarrel and be friends again? It takes very little time, right, to forget everything and start the friendship all over again. Hannah, so dear children, in this story there are two girls, those who have started quarreling, but soon they become friends. And here we have a small twist which we will watch in the story. So let us see it.
Wiser than men. It was an early Easter. Sledging was only just over. Snow still lay in the yards, and water ran in streams down the main street. Two little girls from different houses happened to meet in a lane between two homesteads, where the dirty water, after running through the farmyards, had formed a large puddle. One girl was small, the other a little bigger. Their mothers had dressed them both in new frocks. The little one wore a blue frock, the other wore a yellow one, and the...
So dear children, here there is Easter Day celebrated in this place, and two girls, one is a little elder and the other one is the younger. So Amulya and Malasha, these are the two girls in the story. Now let us see what happens here.
And both had red handkerchiefs on their heads. They had just come from the church when they met. And first they showed each other their finery, and then they began to play. Soon the fancy took them to splash about in the water, and the smaller one was going to step into the puddle, shoes and all, when the elder checked her.
"Don't go in so, Malasha," said she. "Your mother will scold you. I will take off my shoes and stockings, and you take off yours."
So they were thinking of going in that dirty puddle. So do you think the girls will go into the puddle? Let us see what happens.
Their skirts began walking towards each other through the puddle. The water came up to Malasha's ankles, and she said, "It is deep, Akonia, I'm afraid." "Come on," replied the other. "Don't be frightened, it won't get any deeper." When they got near one another, Akonia said, "Mind, Malasha, don't splash, walk carefully." She had hardly said this when Malasha plopped down her foot so that the water splashed right onto Akolia's frock. The frock was splashed, and so were Akolia's eyes and nose. When she saw the stains on her frock, she was angry and ran after Malasha to strike her. Malasha was frightened, and seeing that she had got herself into trouble, she scrambled out of the puddle and prepared to run home. Just then, Akolia's mother happened to be passing, and seeing that her daughter's skirt was splashed and her sleeves dirty, she said, "You naughty, dirty girl, what have you been doing?"
"Malasha did it on purpose," replied the girl.
So what happened next? They both decided to go in the puddle. So the younger ones, she jumped into the puddle first. And what happened? She began to hop and jump. And what happened by this? The elder girl's dress was totally ruined with that dirty, muddy water. And what happened next? You remember? Okay, fine. Let us check. Answer this question. Which word can best replace the phrase on purpose? On purpose means jaan bhujkar karna, means intentionally. Here it was seen that Malasha and Akolya jab khel rahe the, tab dono ki dresses to kharab ho gayi. Then the mother came and फिर क्या बोला the elder girl? She said that the little girl has done this on purpose. मेरी पूरी ड्रेस जो है वो इन्होंने खराब की है. The mother was very angry, right? Now let us see the twist I was talking about.
At this, Akolya's mother seized Malasha and struck her on the back. Malasha began to howl so that she could be heard all down the street. Her mother came out. "What are you beating my girl for?" said she, and began scolding her neighbor. One word led to another, and they had an angry quarrel. The men came out, and a crowd collected in the street, everyone shouting and no one listening. They all went on quarreling.
Will the old lady be able to stop the quarrel? दोनों small girls की वजह से क्या हुआ? उनकी mummies भी fight करने लग गए. And then उनकी grandmother आई and she tried to stop the quarrel. Let us see whether the quarrel has stopped or not.
I listened to the old woman and nearly knocked her. And she would not have been able to quiet the crowd if it had not been for Akolya and Malasha themselves. While the women were abusing each other, Akolya had wiped the mud off her frock and gone back to the puddle. She took a stone and began scraping away the earth in front of the puddle to make a channel through which the water could run out into the street. Presently, Malasha joined her and with a tip of wood, helped her dig the channel, just as the men were beginning to fight. The water from the little girl's channel ran streaming into the street towards the very place where the old woman was trying to pacify the men. The girls followed it, one running each side of the little stream.
"Catch it, Malasha! Catch it!"
shouted the Akolya, while Malasha could not speak. Laughing, highly delighted and watching the chick float along on their stream. The little girls ran straight into the group of men and the old woman, seeing them, said to the men, "Are you not ashamed of yourselves to go on fighting on account of these lassies when they themselves have forgotten all about it and are playing happily together? Dear little souls, they are wiser than you." The men looked at the little girls and were ashamed, and laughing at themselves, each went back to their own homes.
Dear children, the little girls, they forgot about their quarrel and they started playing. Seeing this, grandmother said that these two little girls are wiser than you all because they forgot the quarrel and they have become friends again. Dear children, even we should do the same. We should be wise enough to forgive and forget all the quarrels so that everyone can live in peace and happily. Okay, dear children, let us move on to our exercise section where you need to solve some multiple choice questions.
Tick the correct answer and win a star.
The mothers of Akolya and Malasha had dressed them both in new frocks because they had to go to the church.
They had to go in the church when they met.
So, dear children,
they showed each other their finery.
You have to tick this in your textbook. Next, Malasha dashed and prepared to run home when she found herself in trouble. Scrambled out of puddle, struck her friend or began howling, she scrambled out of the puddle.
What good job!
And seeing that she had got herself into trouble,
so you need to
out of the puddle and prepared to run home.
You need to tick this in your textbook. Malasha began to howl so that everyone could hear her. She could be heard all down the street, or her mother could hear her. Let us see which is the correct answer.
Try again.
No, this is not the correct answer. She could be heard all street down.
Good word. Howl so that she could be heard all down the street. Her mother came out.
So, dear children, you all need to mark these MCQs in your textbook and also try to find the answers of these short questions and answers. I will see you next time with the new words from my dictionary of this lesson. Till then, read the story, enjoy it. And never quarrel with your friends. And if you quarrel, make up quickly. Okay? Bye, dear children. God bless you all.